I'm going to thread on to just the head, right near the eye. I'm not going to thread a base. I'm actually recording this from behind a camera, so I'm not able to see a lot of what I'm doing. I'm going to thread right here in the back. And I've got my piece of green midge wire and one piece of pearl flash glue. What we're trying to do is create a profile on this midge as thin as possible. And we accomplish that by actually adding the material at the head, and then when you are wrapping down your wraps, you want right next to one another without overlapping all the way down, keeping the wire up on top of the hook. That will give you a really thin profile. And grab your whip finisher and whip finish going down the hook. You don't want to whip finish on top of the previous wrap. And then nip that off. Go back up to the bead and thread back on. And that's just to tie off the materials as we wrap them forward. Now the flashaboo, when you wrap this, I find that if I stretch it, the bug will have a blue hue to it. And that's not what we're looking for. Though some bugs, like damsels and things, probably would be advantageous. But this is just a wrap, one right next to one another. Don't stretch it. Just be kind of firm with the wrap. If you miss a spot, you can go back to it. And if this flashaboo, if you lose grip of it and it starts to unwind, just stick your finger right up on top of the bug and that'll stop it. You can kind of go back and back it back up. Wrap it off. You can see that's a nice thin profile, almost just the thickness of the hook. Counter palmer your wire. Not too close together, there's about 4 or 5 wraps all the way up. Tie this off. And your peacock curl, I've only got 2 pieces here. You're not looking for a big thorax or anything. This little bug can be made all the way down to size 20. Usually the size that I make is a 10. Works the best that I've seen. We've finished this. And then instead of head cement, I used to use UV Notsense, and if it's brand new out of the container, UV Notsense works really well, but as soon as it starts getting thick, it doesn't penetrate. So I use Softex, which is a good product for even waiter repair and realistic bugs. It penetrates quite well. And that's the Boot Scootin' Boogie, BSB, that's what we call it. Nice little thin profile bug.